You know what? If you go to macweldon.com right now, you get 20% off using the promo code SHRIMPS. Do it. I've done it. You'll do it. We won't be sorry together.
Next week, I'm going to have me some Mac Weldons. I ordered them.
Oh,
I'm ready to
rock. This is exciting. And that brings us to tonight's Pistol Shrimps action. It's time for me to get into my voice. I'm not wearing headphones, so it's weird.
Are you not wearing?
It's real
because your headphones are weird. The game has started, folks. This is Pistol Shrimps Radio. We're at North Weddington Gymnasium. My name is Mark McConville.
My name is Matt Gourley.
And right out the gate, our opponent tonight just scored the misdemeanors in their black uniforms.
That's right. It's the misdemeanors facing off against these, our shrimps. Tonight's starting lineup, Jesse Thomas, number 99. Stephanie the Scarlet Netter Allen, number 19. Melissa Stettlers of Catan, number 3. Amanda Funbun Lun, that's both buns, 9. And Laura Lightset Jack, 25.
Well, Matt, it's 4-0 already in favor of the misdemeanors, who are starting number 31, number 23, number 7, number 33, and probably the captain of the team, number 6. No way to know. We didn't check in with them.
It's already 4-0. I don't like the way this season is going.
You got bad vibes on it, do you?
I do, but, you know, with all bad vibes comes a lot of rhyme failures.
Speaking of failures, the misdemeanors just stole the ball. 3-on-1 fast break, and that's good. It's 6-0 in favor.
Six
of the
is, of
misdemeanors.
Course, a number divisible only by the numbers that will go into it. And so y'all see the symbolism there. I haven't had anything to eat but a piece of pizza that was sent to us by a mystery person.
If you're the mystery person, we'd love to hear all about what possessed you to order us a pizza, but we're...
Are there 3 kinds of meat on there?
Looks like a sausage and pepperoni number.
Mark, I hate to interrupt you, but the shrimps have scored a point. They've put themselves on the board and doubled it for 2.
That was Stephanie Allen with a nifty little shot there. Okay, now the these are the misdemeanors. They have the ball. They're going to dribble. They're going to pass. Picked off almost by Stephanie Allen. A lot of rebound opportunities here at the North Weddington Gym. 31 with the ball. She will pass to number 7, who drives to the hoop. No good. Oh, it is good.
It is
good. That looked no good, and then it was good.
Yeah.
It's a real trick shot there.
What do you know about that? I'm going to turn off my noise-canceling thing on my headphones. It's driving me up the belfry.
See if that see if that'll help you. Jesse Thomas with the ball. Point guard at half court. She'll dribble. She'll make a little move. Boy, she just broke an ankle right there. 6 went down like a sack of potatoes. Wicked crossover dribble from Thomas, but that basket didn't go in. It's still 6-2 in favor of the misdemeanors.
Well, I haven't eliminated the echo in my headphones, but I think I turned on my living room lights at home.
We live in an app-slapping world, don't we?
I just unlocked the door if you want to stop by and take us something.
Oh, we got some free throws here, Matt. Let's talk about free throw shit you can do with apps.
Okay, well, you can mistakenly unlock your front door.
Sure, no good on the free throw. Still 6-2, I think.
That's right. Fun Buns Lawn being subbed out by Paisley Gray, number 53. All the girls in fine form this last week when we went to the Tribeca Film Festival for the premiere of the Pistol Shrimps documentary. Those are good for 2 points there in the free throws land.
Well, if you've never visited the North Weddington Gymnasium before, there's a real legit couple of scoreboards mounted on the walls, and then they use this little sort of iPad mini to have the score up. So I think it's 8-3.
Well, there's no way to know because it really is the size of an iPad mini.
But Stephanie Allen knows the score because she just scored with the ball in the net.
All of a sudden, the Shrimps are back in this game. Now, I'm getting excited about this. It'd be nice to see a Pistol Shrimps victory for the season.
Block shot there by Allen. That's going to be free throws.
Is it? Am I mistaken, or did the referee come in late and just join the game?
Matt, of course, that's referee Early Ramirez.
And being accompanied by a referee, late Gonzalez.
23 for the misdemeanors, just put in a free throw, so it's probably 10-5. Nice rebound by Paisley Gray. Shrimps are going to try to rally back here from an early deficit.
That's
I might have to get up and go see what the score is.
Is it not 5-10?
Can you see that?
With 60, I have great angular vision.
It's like you ever watch a HD TV from the side?
That's all I do.
You can put your chairs in other places in your house, Matt.
Don't want to. The light is too bright. I like to. Same thing with my smartphone. I like looking at an angle. You know what I mean? That's mostly how I watch people from inside their homes.
Nice shot from the misdemeanors. No good. 33 will pass out to 6. So think about a shot. She's guarded by Thomas.
Mark, we got a big treat tonight. I'm going to draw something on your forehead.
I just figured it was time.
It'd been a while since I've done it, and we need that kind of bonding activity. I put a Twitter poll up and had 4 choices. The votes are soundly in the corner of one of the choices. I'll reveal that in a little bit.
What if I don't want you to do it?
Well, Mark, I don't know how we'd not do it. What do I get to draw on you? Offered as an option.
Stephanie Allen with a wide open 3.
You can draw a small freckle or
I'll draw a small freckle on you.
You can draw a pore. Let's go ahead and look at the tally here.
Long pass there from the misdemeanors.
I'm already going to tell you right now, with only 8% of the vote after 378 votes in currently, it will not be a severed foot drawn on your forehead, Mark.
Why was that on the list?
I just like drawing feet.
Is that true?
It's true. I find the arch of the foot, when viewed from a 3/4 angle, is a... You ever had 3/4 anger?
Yeah, I've got a little bit of it right now.
Yeah.
Misdemeanors do too. They are hot tonight.
Have 3/4 anger, you have to go to anger assistant management classes. Hey, Mark, how's it like being my great partner in this?
I would give anything else in the world to not be here. Enough double negatives for you?
enough double negatives. I'm enough double negative. Starring in tonight's feature film, This Is a Movie, Man. How's Cohen? I'm Crispin Glubber.
Everyone's favorite TV movie star.
And least favorite movie TV star. You're my depths today.
A lot of ball movement, but Laura Lights Out Jack puts an end to that.
Dep.
Stolen. Did I ever use what?
Dep.
The gel?
Yeah.
I probably did.
All right. Don't tell me anything more.
Did you ever use it?
Hell yeah, I did.
Still using it today.
Toot toot from Scoot Scoot.
I feel like we were so loud. I feel like everyone
in
this gym can hear
us. I know, it's a real quiet night. I do.
It's an early game.
It is an early game. I don't have headphones on, so I can't tell what kind of register I'm talking in. This is a very special episode of Pistol Shrimps Radio. I just got to look from the ref.
Yes, we got to shut up.
This is very dangerous.
There's a fly on our pizza, Matt.
Oh, missed.
There's flies all over the place on these pizza. Where did these flies come from? I'm serious. I guess we're out. There's a park right outside. But it's like, really? You couldn't wait half an hour for the game to be over?
Oh, there's a point. Bringing the score to one team something, the other team another thing.
Could be 14 to
5 to 14. Is it 8?
I don't know.
Oh, that looks like 5 to 14.
Looks like 5.
Do you have some kind of weird vision that you can only see straight on?
Coach is also having trouble with the scoreboard, too.
Oh.
Just to be fair. Thomas just got tomahawked,
Mark,
over the head.
Maybe now's the time to tell you, you've got ocular blind spots tonight on PBS Action Theater.
Ocular blind spot, of course, stars
Laura Linney,
Peebo Bryson,
Kanji Club,
Kanye West,
Kanye East,
Northwest.
Kanye West? I don't know how much West. You see, this is a podcast.
And what we do is...
talk into these mics.
When basketball's happening.
And you reap the benefits and or burdens.
We
tonight,
don't know a ton about basketball, but we're learning quick.
I do want to say this. If you're just tuning into Pistol Shrimps Radio, perhaps it's because of the wonderful write-up Nathan Rabin gave us on Split Cider. But I'd like to say this. If you feel at any time like you're missing out on a reference... and you want to go back and check, don't worry about it.
No, don't. Why would you? Don't waste your time on this precious earth.
Don't go back and listen to podcasts. In fact, don't even listen to this one. Skip ahead to the next one.
You feel like you're phoning this one in? Why would you skip this one?
I don't know. That was just a joke, but I don't feel like I'm phoning this in. I feel like I'm 3 hogs to the ground.
Is this ref going to the airport? He really was late. He just flew in from San Jose.
Yeah.
Landed at Burbank Airport, grabbed a root beer float at that weird sort of discount Johnny Rockets, brought his carry-on over here.
That's true.
He's signing in right now. He was late.
The scorekeeper, never ceases to fascinate me. He looks like one of the Dead Poets Society that went out to that cave but then just stayed for a while.
I think he lives here. Hey, Matt, we got a timeout, so we might as well open a thing.
He has a real bushy hair and a real bushy beard, but to the extent where it looks like he's wearing a head wig and a beard wig. You ever watch Hedwig the Angry Bench?
Did I watch it?
I don't know. A fella comes to the show tonight, and he says, I've got a gift for you fellas, and it's wrapped like a present.
It sure is.
Wonderful. His name again was...
I believe this was from Nick, and these are from Carson.
Okay, Carson brought us treats. I've already had one of them.
Tennessee treats, moon pies, and goo-goo dolls. Clusters.
These are from the two towns wherein he lived. Well, we're back in the game. We'll open this present in a minute.
We missed our opportunity.
Why am I whispering? It feels like library basketball gameplay tonight.
Because I feel like we're louder than we need to be.
There's something odd about this game. This is like... Uh-oh, it's a big shot by the misdemeanors. It's no good. Rebound.
Paisley fights for the rebound, but Stephanie Allen takes it.
Would you say that rebound was shared by Paisley and Stephanie?
That might be a half a rebound for each. Oh, my goodness.
Rebound.
Did you see that move from Jessie Thomas? It's like she hired a choreographer to fake people.
Oh, 3 points from Laura Lights Out Jack. Check out the Pistol Shrimps documentary streaming your way soon. You'll learn a little bit about why she got the name Lights Out Jack, and I'll tell you a little spoiler. It has to do with three-pointers like we just saw.
I hate to tell you, that was a two-pointer.
Well, taking the name away. Laura Lights Dimmed Jack.
The light, she just sort of unscrewed one of the light bulbs a little bit, so it's a little...
That you have to do a little finger tap on it before you get shot in the cheek like the guy in Godfather 2.
That's what I'm talking about.
You knew, I knew.
Thomas is walking up the court, dribbling the basketball.
Dribbling
the basketball.
Oh, stolen by a misdemeanor. Passes to the fast break, but it goes out of bounds on an errant play. This is Pistol Shrimps B-Ball. My name is me.
And I am you. You're on the podcast right now.
We are all together.
Caller, you're calling from Chattanooga. Why don't you go ahead and tell us about your Pistol Shrimps basketballs.
Also, we were delivered...
Holy smokes. Jessie Thomas just said, you know what? I think I'll take a shot right now from way far away from the basket.
Excuse me, while we were just gumming around and doing a bullshit dick around, the Shrimps have basically come back. It's 12-14.
It is?
Yep.
I can't see the scoreboard.
And the game is suddenly back into exciting territory. Referee does his thing.
Don't know
what that thing is, but it involves a steel sound maker.
That's referee Rainey Gillane.
The other referee is just hanging out with his hands behind his back.
He really looks like
misdemeanors put it up, but it's no good. Rebounded by Laura Lights Out Jack, who will pass to Tally Levy Crouch. Tally surveys the field and pops it right back to Jessie Thomas. She's always the one that brings it up. Court. What do you call that?
That's the point guard, Matt.
Okay.
The point guard generally will distribute the ball, pass it, assess the defense, and decide what we're going to do. We got a jump ball. Paisley Gray got her hands on it. And the very casual referee, Anderson Pooper. I feel like I've said that before.
Anderson Cooper's Mandarin Pooper?
Sure.
Lou Rawls Balls? What are they doing now? They're all getting together for a thing.
Yeah, this is a little inbound pass.
Lights the back to Jessie like to Thomas. Jessie Thomas outside the three-point circle. Ooh, with a hard pass indoors.
Whipped it in there.
Wow, but it ends up in misdemeanor's possession. But it's intercepted and then back intercepted. What do you call that?
Paisley Gray almost intercepted that pass. It went off her hands and then it went into the hands of the misdemeanors.
Put it up for it's 12-16. For it is 12-16. Nothing like a little old English basketball. Come ye all, taste your legs and use them hence down to your recreational housing thatch.
Oh, behind the back pass there.
Stephanie Allen into the key.
I like that. If you have to describe something, can you do it in Old English?
Sure. What do you want described?
The game.
Oh. Is that what we're doing? maidens of demeanors with holding balls.
Harder than you think, folks. I wouldn't even...
What pimply orb shall be passed hence from female to maiden? And then, gaining one so much as not one but 2 points, raising their stakes and the visage of their lover's eyes looking from upon side field, glancing not at their visages, but more at their prowess.
Folks, this weekend at the Old Globe Theater in London, England, Shakespeare's lost play, The Wedding at North Weddington.
And this Friday at New Globe Theater in San Diego, Chalapanas.
Oh, who's here?
I backed into it.
Hey, how are you, Kuvich?
Well, I don't know this, but I love Ooch.
Well, why don't you open there? Somebody got you a present there, Kubich.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to open notch. Kubich, open notch.
Rebound by Stephanie Allen. I'll call the game. You open that present,
Kubich. Kubich, open it.
Stephanie Allen will march the ball up. That Jesse Thomas is going to go to the corner, see if she can maybe get a three-pointer. Allen will drive to the right.
These are bucks from Amazuchi Primos.
Tally Levy Crouch passes to Jack. Jack puts up a shot. It kind of teases us and does not go in. So the misdemeanors are coming at us.
I got the open niche.
Kubich ripping into a box. Misdemeanors with a shot from the low post. That's in.
I don't have my ladder open niche because we fly to New York, coach.
Were you on that flight,
Kubich? Yapis.
I didn't know you came with.
Yeah.
You didn't. I didn't see you in New York. What'd you do the whole time you were there?
Binocular juice.
What'd you do while you were in New York, Kubich?
Multi-scorebatch.
Oh, look at that. We need a timeout here from Coach Chris Vanger.
I don't know what I missed, but I'm back. But these binoculars will come in very handy to see the scoreboard.
Yeah, I could probably use them. It looks like it's 22-13. Can you tell?
I see in 12-22. I honestly, you're at a more head-on angle than I am. I don't know
if it's glare off the floor. It's hard to tell. Look.
I think it's an IQ problem.
Look. Referee Marsh Shapiro.
Yeah.
And referee Alex. Man, the way he looks at Manny. Who is he now? He's Donnie.
You've got to love the glimmer on the floor. I'll tell you what's more, when you see your own reflection in a basketball delection. What is the meaning of the word delection? Well, I'll tell you in the end of this song. From Webster's Collegiate Dictionary, it's a verb, it's a noun, and it's kind of scary because what's a verb and a noun with an ing? It's a gerund running round. My name is Dictionary Lounge Jim, and I do hotel word songs where you and your mistress come and wish you were up there giving it the old hayseed wet around.
And I'm Thesaurus Monk, and what I do is just play improvised jazz slaps. I just take my fingers and rub them on the black and whites.
I tickle the ivories, and the game
Jesse
is back
Thomas
on.
Thomas passes
God.
Over to Stephanie Allen. Allen to Tally Levy Crouch. Wide open shot. That's an air ball. No good. Goes out of bounds over the back line.
I think it's what it's called. 6 minutes left in the first half of this, the third game of Pistol Shrimps. Mark, do you already know who the guest is going to be to replace me next week?
I really don't.
All right.
I got some people in mind, but I haven't asked anybody yet.
Is one of them Larry Bird or a Brent Musburger?
You know, my wife, who made a brief appearance on the Tribeca Red Carpet Film Festival episode of our podcast,
yeah,
she thinks I should try to get Snoop Dogg.
Why not?
Do you think he'd do it?
I used to live on his street.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Down in Long Beach?
Way down south.
Oh, so just quite a distance from where he probably really actually lived. Laura lights out, Jack turns, tries to shoot. She's fouled, I think.
Who's fouled?
I think Laura lights out, Jack was fouled her shot attempt, so she'll shoot what are known as free throws.
You don't have to pay for them. But you know what? Guess who does? The taxpayer.
And that happened on Monday. You had to have your taxes in.
That's a good thing because we have free throws tonight, and they would have been unfunded.
I don't even know what the contingency plan is for unpaid free throws.
Tally Levy Crouch and Paisley Gray taking the bench while Amanda Funbuns Lunn and Melissa Stetton take the field.
Nice rebound from Stephanie Allen. She will get another rebound. She gets it ripped out of her hands, and she is mad.
Another rebound.
That ball went off Jesse Thomas out of
bounds. Four musical notes from the hit Bare Naked Ladies song, Another Postcard.
What?
Another postcard of chimpanzees.
I feel like you got way more into Bare Naked Ladies than I did.
Than anyone?
Can you name all of the members of Bare Naked Ladies?
Hell yeah. Which makeup.
Let's start with the original lineup.
Stephen Page.
Yeah, that's easy.
Ed Roberts.
Also easy. Now we're getting in.
Jim and Andrew Cregan.
Oh, boy.
Tyler. Ugh.
Folks, it's Bare Naked Ladies Night down here at North Weddington Gymnasium.
That's
right. Every member of the studio audience of this basketball game will go home with a fully clothed bare naked lady.
You can undress him if you'd like.
Yeah.
Tyler.
Just don't give any of them cocaine. One of them has a major problem.
Tyler. Oh, this is killing me.
Laura lights out Jackson on the perimeter.
Andrew Cregan leaves the band, right?
Yeah.
And then so then they're in stasis for a while, but then they take on Kevin Hearn.
Allen passes to Jack to Thomas.
And then, as we all know, on that horrible day.
Thomas with a bucket there.
All right, keep it down. We're talking about Bare Naked Ladies. On that horrible day that Stephen Page left the band and left a rift in all of our hearts, because was he the heart? Was he the soul of the band? I don't know, but it hasn't been the same ever since. Stephen, if you're out there listening, come back. We need you.
Is he the fellow with the drug problem?
I think
Did he crash his own plane or something like
no,
that?
No, that's Ed Roberts. But I don't believe that was drug-related, but Stephen Page was the one that had a drug issue. I don't think he has a drug problem. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt.
Free throw. Money in the bank on that free throw from 33.
And a good investment, civic investment.
Yeah.
Anyway.
What's
your favorite Bare Naked Ladies album?
Album? I mean, I probably had that Born on a Pirate Ship.
That's a goodie.
That's probably the one. Gordon. I'm trying to remember the ones.
Well,
the extent of my Bare Naked Ladies is this. I got Born on a Pirate Ship.
That's their third album.
Then I got Spectacle, the live one.
Oh, you mean Spectacle. It's supposed to be pronounced French.
All right. Well, I don't remember what it's called. It's the live one.
Yeah.
And that's got that Brian lying in bed just like Brian Wilson.
That's on Gordon.
Yeah. Then I got Gordon. Then I got the
So Bad Sometimes I Can't Sit Down.
Chickity Chat of the Chinese Chicken, that record.
Yeah.
The one week record.
Sure.
And then I stopped caring. Oh, boy. Jesse Thomas coming up.
Oh, my God. There are pistol shrimps in the house. Laura lights out. Jack, how you doing, Laura? Taking a breather. We're on a stage, and there are two pistol shrimps up here that are currently in the game.
I tried to turn the microphone there, and boy, it was just a disaster.
Well, it's time to read the second forehead drawing that will not make it to Mark's pate tonight.
Foot off the ball, and that's not a thing that happened at all.
399 votes in so far.
That's barely a quorum. I don't think you can even draw anything on
with
my head.
With 13% of the vote, this was my pick. I'm bummed it's not going to happen, but you will not have Rambo on your forehead.
Matt, it's 20. Oh, boy. Laura lights out. Jack just put up two. It's 26-16 with 130 left in the first half. You know who I'm not seeing here, Matt? Greg Escalante.
Huh? No soccer report tonight.
I don't think
huh?
we're going to get a soccer report,
That's right.
so we
we'll
better.
We'll do a forehead drawing.
Right there at halftime?
Yeah, why
you
not?
You got to give me a break. There's not even any paper towels in the bathroom if I want to clean
you
this thing off.
You can wipe a greasy piece of pizza.
I want to eat some pizza so bad. It falls right apart. Jesse Thomas gets a rebound. Got a minute left here in the half. So the Shrimps have got 10 points to score here if they want to tie the game before the half, which they're probably not going to do, to be honest. Because that's a lot of points to score in 1 minute. Plus, the clock doesn't stop. God damn this league.
They do have a clock problem. They're a bunch of mad hatters running this circus. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm late. I'm late for an important date. So goes. Yeah.
Why don't you have a tiny bottle of Aquafina and see what it does to your size?
Drink me. Did you ever play Dragon's Lair, Mark?
The video game?
No. No,
the play at home board game.
The recipe book.
I have played the video game, Dragon's Lair. Very frustrating game to play. I never want to play it again.
Oh, no, I disagree.
Have you beaten it?
I have, but only because I had to buy the DVD where you play with your remote control.
That's right.
There was a year where I had a lot of closure in my life. I finally saw Def Leppard. I finally completed Dragon's Lair. Then I realized it's halftime.
Thomas
I realized
just put
they
up
both
a shot
start
there.
With a D and an L. Now, put that into your star charts and see what doesn't matter.
Jesse Thomas put up a long shot that almost went in there at the end of the half, but it was no good. So what we've got here is a 20-something to a teen-something
to communicate
here in the halftime.
All right. The third forehead option that isn't going to happen tonight with 32% of the vote, not a bad showing, is a xenomorph, an alien xenomorph.
Well, what? Hold on a second. What are you drawing this with?
A pen.
Just a pen?
Yeah.
For
you and me are the only two people I know that carry around these Uniball.
Yeah, I like a Uniball.
I do too.
We should get sponsored by Uniball.
Oh, wouldn't that be great? Because I'm always wanting these.
I always buy these in bulk. I do too. I see a bunch of them, though, I will tell you, the Vision Elite is starting to fall a little flat.
I don't like those. This isn't even my favorite Uniball. I like the more robust casing one.
You like a bold?
Yeah.
What kind of
Pistol Shrimps basketball is brought to you by a pen?
Write stuff down with it, and I hope you don't want to erase it.
It's time with 47% of the vote, with a total of 399 votes. Tonight's drawing on Mark's forehead will be a weird mall kid.
All right. Well, let me see if I can get a video of this going.
Okay.
So you can.
So you I'm gonna
wait a minute.
Pull off the mic here,
Matt.
I gotta
hold
see
the
it.
Hell on. Yeah. All right. Can you flip around the video camera?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go.
But I need you to face me.
No one's talking, Matt. This is really. How big of a kid you drawing here?
Pretty big.
All right, well, this is like bizarre theater for people. How weird's the kid?
Well, I haven't gotten to that part.
How detailed are you going to make this shit?
Pretty.
Come on. We don't have that much time. Well, somebody has to talk, man. It's a podcast. There's people listening to it. They can't see what. I didn't move. I'm very still. The game is starting.
Oh, you draw. Like beard.
You drew a kid with a beard. The hell is wrong with you, Matt? All right, second half starting. I got as much of a weird mall kid as you can get. Matt is. He will not be deterred. Well, oh yeah, stop for a second so someone can take your picture. That's about it, Matt. The game has started, for crying out loud. You have to be done. All right, folks, there it is, the weird mauled kid.
Wait, I'm not done.
Well, what if I'm done?
I haven't made him weird yet.
Now you're watching the video of it.
You're sweating and it won't.
I can't stop that. What do you want from me?
Let me just make him weird.
He's already pretty weird, I can tell. Well, the game has started back up again. Matt's pen's out of ink. Forget it, Uniball. We're not interested. I can't see anything because Matt's hand's on my head. So there's a game going on and the misdemeanors have the ball. Something else is going on. We got a snack delivery. You got a what? Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. It's very nice of you.
Matt, you got to stop because the game is going on. The misdemeanors have the ball. It's done. It has to be done. I'm going to mess it up. Nice steal from Allen. Allen passes to Jack. You're not almost done. You're just saying that to keep yourself drawing.
I'm just going to give him a cigarette.
Jack dribbles up. She spins. She puts up a shot off the front rim. No good. Rebound.
Let me get a picture.
I already took a video of it.
Well, let me get a picture. Mark, I don't know why you're being difficult about this.
I can't believe this.
Look at me.
I can't believe this, Matt. This is horse shit.
Look at me, Mark.
I'm looking here. We got a stoppage in play and a stoppage in the podcast. Matt can't talk and draw, and he also can't talk and take a picture. Free throws here.
You're listening to Pistol Shrimps Radio. My name is Matt Gorley.
No good on the free throw there. I'm Mark McConville. Matt drew a weird mall kid on my head.
He's
I never get to draw on your head.
And you never will. That's not true, Mark. You can draw my head sometime.
I'm a terrible artist. I can't do that.
My weird mall kid is a smoking angel.
That checks out. That'd be a pretty weird mall kid. Well, we got more food delivered to us from a stranger, and Jesse Thomas has the ball. Showed long pass there to Stetton. Stetton gets the ball, sort of taken out of her hand. What? That ball went off a blast. Well,
you want to see Mark with his weird mall kid forehead tattoo the size of South America on a globe? Check out Instagram. My name is Matt Gorley on Instagram, and it'll probably be on Pistol Shrimps Radio Instagram. What is the Pistol Shrimps Radio Instagram?
Pistol Shrimps Radio on Instagram. Shrimps Radio on Twitter. We'll put it on both, and you can see what Matt's work of art on my head. Why he does that, I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
Why wouldn't I?
It's just a weird... You're a weird mall kid, Matt. You want my honest opinion? You're a weird mall kid.
How do you think I know so much about him? I was a weird mall kid. In fact, I'm probably a weird mall adult now, to be honest.
That's right. We did talk about your mall walking earlier in the season, didn't we? Here's the problem with Pistol Shrimps Radio. I never remember what the hell we talked about. Once again, Matt not talking in any way, shape, or form. Just fooling around with his phone. As the misdemeanors score. I feel the less Matt talks, the more the misdemeanors score.
Oh, don't blame me for this.
I really am going to blame.
Okay, I'm almost.
I'm going to blame you.
Gungan blame me. Don't Gungan blame me.
You said do a bad job, man. Means I like it this.
Somehow the misdemeanors have the ball again. Fast break. Bucket. 33 scores. She's on fire. Vanger wants a timeout. We're getting a weird sort of...
Hold on, I'm just tagging you.
Air karate chop. Yeah, go ahead. Take your time.
Okay, how are we doing? What's the score? Who's playing? What's going on?
Why don't you open another thing, because we're at a timeout here.
Okay, I'm going to open up this Dylon envelope.
I already opened it, so you just go in and grab what you're grabbing. That's airmail, so I don't know where it's from. Check that out. Where is it from, Matt?
North Somerset in the UK. Little colored thimbles. These are British thimbles.
No, those are no good. I've tried those before.
You can't because there's an adapter problem.
Yeah, there's like a... Yeah. Those are metric.
These are PAL format thimbles.
Yeah, that's... This I mean, I appreciate the gesture.
That's nice, but it won't work.
It's. I have tried it. So it'll do in a pinch.
Best. It'll.
And then
it'll
pinch also
you.
Pinch.
These are the rubber kind.
Is there a little note on there?
Yeah, best to send an anvil, I think.
Probably not.
Full anvil.
I would disagree vehemently with that.
Yeah, there is a note. Thanks for buying on Amazon Marketplace. To provide feedback for the seller, please visit. This is from Michelle Normando. Oh, a little French name. Normando.
It's from
very nice.
England?
I do like French surnames. There's something about it.
Name
French
five
lady
French.
From England. Wow.
Long shot from Jesse
All of the
Thomas.
Allies represented. French lady in England, send into America. That's big time. It's like we're back in WW2. This is Pistol Shrimps B-Ball. There has been an awakening. It's
Stetton needs to shoot.
Is it really 16-38?
Yes, Matt, it is. You've been drawing this whole goddamn time.
Where was I?
You were drawing a weird mall kid on my head.
Well, we got to find the right drawing to score these girls some points. There it is. Jesse Thomas puts it up for 2 basketball points.
It's time to get into it, Matt. This is Pistol Shrimps Radio.
We'll do our typical second half rally when all the sugar I've piped down my gaping maw starts to really kick in.
You had a goo-goo cluster earlier.
Yeah. Do you ever watch the Pippi Longstocking where they make the car fly on that shoe glue?
The Pippi Longstocking?
Well,
is there
the
an episode
one.
Of it?
No, there's a movie.
I feel like I saw that maybe when I was 10. I don't remember.
That's what's going on here.
Well,
Oscar.
Jesse Thomas has the ball.
Oscar.
Is that from the movie?
Yeah. When she's in with the pirate.
Thomas getting triple teamed.
Do you know?
Wide open. Stephanie Allen tries for a layup.
She pops it up. Inger Nilsson, who played Pippi Longstocking, first crush. First erotic dream I think I ever had.
Oh, boy. In and out, no good for the, what team are they playing? The Misdemeanors. I don't know. Yeah. I have ink poisoning, so my brain isn't working very well. Jesse Thomas will dribble up to half court.
I've got goo-goo cluster poisoning.
I'm sure you do.
Oh, man, these are good, though. I don't mind saying.
Did you eat the other one? I want to try that.
Right
Well, I don't want to eat right now.
You want a moon pie or do you want a poon pie? Mark McConville, sometimes the fact that you get to be my friend must be nice.
Sometimes you get a weird mall kid drawn on your head.
And sometimes you're the windshield, sometimes you're the bug. That's a lyric from a Dire Straits song.
Is that Dire Straits?
That's right. It's called The Bug. It was late in their career. In fact, I think it was their last album, Calling Elvis,
Interception,
1991.
Stolen.
Golly.
What a bunch of shit.
Golly, ma. Shook today.
Don't leave my heart.
Let's see if I can make any more goddamn movie references tonight.
That's all you do, really, isn't it?
I am the Abed of Pistol Shrimps Radio.
Did you watch any movies on the flight to or from New York?
Yes, I did.
Jesse Thomas. Smooth.
I watched a little indie called Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens.
Again. You watched it again.
Well, it's not going to watch me.
You see anything new this time?
Sure did.
What?
This one credit.
Poe Dameron's jacket had a different crease in it this time.
That'd be awesome if it did, but it didn't.
There's a stoppage in play.
Do you notice Han Solo's jacket in that movie is made out of some kind of like crushed leather, like you do crushed velvet?
You know what you don't really ever see in a Star Wars movie?
Tits.
This is Pistol Shrimps Radio. I was going to say a store. Like you see trading posts.
Well, trading posts.
But you don't really see like... a Target.
Well, no, you don't. You also don't see the show Full House in Star Wars. It's a different universe, Mark. Well, universe in the narrative sense, it's just a different galaxy in the physical sense.
It's 42
sense, it
to 20 in favor of the team in black. Matt, this season's really different from last season, isn't it?
It sure is, but it's more like the old seasons. But you know what? We're all having a good time, and who cares who wins, because life is a series of losses.
You
lose cells.
You gain one, and you lose two. I think it's...
Do you notice that life is a series of gains, and then it's losses?
Gains and Losses,
yeah.
Starring Michael Douglas.
That's right. Entropy Rambole.
Candice Bergen.
Bandis Kurgan. What kind of camera is that?
That's a little iPod, Matt.